Palpation of the male differs in its technique from that of the cow. Because the genitalia of the male, as you see here, the two uterine horns are nearly in the same length as the uterine body. And these two, the uterine horns and the body, are handled in the sublumbar region of the abdomen. And also, here, the cervix is not so rigid or hard consistency like the cattle. So the guide for me in rectal palpation of the male, we take it to the right oval. So I introduce my hand forward here in the sublumbar region and try to hold the oval. Then be sure that this is exactly, or this is sure that this is the ovary from palpation, or just to manipulate it. And then proceed from the ovary down to the right horn, then to the... The technique in the male differs from that of cattle. We didn't try to find or palpate the cervix because it could not be recognized. It is very flabby and not of hard consistency. So two horns and two ovaries are handled here in the sublumbar region. So I introduced my hand. Then I hold first the left ovary. So I hold the left ovary, estimate or diagnose its size, and see the ovulation fossa or depression. Then proceed downward. This is the ovary. I must be sure that this is the ovary, not a fecal mound. Then proceed downward with the left horn to see its structures. Then reach the bifurcation of the two horns. And I have to choose one of two ways. Either to continue, but I have to direct my body. Then I hold the right of horn, and in this manner, till the end. And at the end of the right horn, I start to hold the right ovary. You see its structure here, this also hand into the sublumbar region, and you see the structures of the ovary, its size, and so on. And by this manner, I forget the two ovaries, the two uterines. The an easy method is that you forget the left side by the right hand, and you finish, then you introduce your left hand to palpate the right side. And this is somewhat easier, but it means that you have to pollute or introduce your two hands one after the other. So, palpation of the male, we introduce it very easy, and you must palpate and not manipulate, because the male rectum is very smooth, very delicate, and any abrasions may make tetanic infection. And so, you have to be very gentle in palpation. You introduce your hand in the sublumbar region, then you start to palpate the left ovary by your right hand, that you introduce it. Be sure that it is the left ovary, because of its kidney shape and the depression in the center. And you can pull it somewhat from its place. Be sure that it is not a fecal ball that you are doing. Then you proceed downward to palpate the left horn till the bifurcation. So you have to turn your body to palpate the right horn in this manner by the flat fingers and not hard manipulation. Then till you reach the right ovary. It's also handled in the sublumbar region. You start to estimate its size, the contents of the ovary. This one, male 2 months pregnancy, you notice the swelling here in the right horn near the bifurcation. This is in the size of a tennis ball. So the palpation and the palpation, the diagnosis of pregnancy in the male is done in the same manner that I palpate the left ovary by my right hand, proceed downward to see the left form. Then at the bifurcation, start to turn my body. Here there is swelling and there is fluctuation. You feel this fluctuation. please don't to do what we call it hit and mislead as in cattle. This is wrong, my mistake, and may disturb the parents. Only you palpate very gently his swelling, and you can feel the palpation, fluctuation of the fetus. And there is asymmetry between the right horn and the left horn. Then you proceed forward or upward till the right ovary, and here it is maintaining a corpus luteum is present here in the ovulation fossa or ovulation depression. So this animal or this mare is pregnant in 2 months of pregnancy. Notice the fluctuation here near the fluctuation of the